Review test, units 5 and 6.
You saw Anna yesterday, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
I haven't seen her for a few weeks. How is she? She must be so happy now she's going out with Luis.
Well, actually, she's the opposite. She's really sad.
Really? The last time I saw her, she said she wanted to get engaged to him.
I know. She's really fallen in love with him, hasn't she?
So what happened?
Well, about 2 weeks ago, she discovered a message from another girl on Luis's cell phone. It looked a bit strange, so she searched for more messages from the girl on his phone and found about 10 of them.
Who is the girl? Do you know her?
Yes, I do. It's Isabel, my sister's friend.
Isabel? Well, she has always liked Luis, hasn't she?
Yes, she has, and Anna immediately thought Luis might have cheated on her with Isabel.
Did she say anything to him?
Yes, she told him she had seen the messages.
Luis must have been angry.
He was furious. He told her she shouldn't have looked at his phone, and they had an enormous argument. But he didn't admit anything.
Well, I suppose he was right in a way, wasn't he? It was his phone, not Anna's. But I'm not surprised. There was a lot of gossip last year that he did the same thing with another girl.
I know. And then last week, Anna saw Luis and Isabel together.
Really? Where were they? Anna must have been so upset.
They were in a cafe together. They were sitting very close to each other, Anna says.
Well, that proves it, doesn't it? He's definitely cheating on her, isn't he?
Well...
So what did Anna do? Did she say anything to them?
No, she walked away. She called me about it and sounded very upset.
But has Luis been different when he's with Anna?
Anna said he hasn't called her much in the last few weeks. She knows something is wrong.
Well, if she saw him in a cafe with Isabel, that explains everything, doesn't it?
Maybe.
Well, I guess she should break up with him.
But she really likes him.
She does, doesn't she? Oh, poor Anna. I wonder what she's going to do.
Well, the thing is, Luis says that he isn't cheating on Anna. He told her that Isabel is an old friend and that they often send each other messages and meet for coffee.
And does Anna believe him?
Yes, she does. He might be telling the truth, you know.
Oh, David, you can't be serious. We should go and see Anna. This can't be easy for her.
You're right. I think we should.
Review test. Units 7 and 8.
Today, on the Innovation Show, I'm with Carla Price in her furniture and clothing store, where things are always that little bit different. Now, Carla just told me she was going to tell us about a new bamboo product in her store. Is that right, Carla?
Yes, it is. As you know, bamboo is a fantastic material. It looks like a tree, but scientists say it isn't a tree. It's actually a type of grass, but it can grow incredibly tall in a very short time. It's amazingly strong, and we can use it for a whole variety of different purposes. We can build houses with it, make furniture with it. A lot of people's floors are made of it, and we can do lots of other things, too.
It's even used in cooking, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Bamboo is one of my favorite vegetables.
So, what is this product you've brought here today? Is it the chair you're sitting on?
No, it isn't.
It can't be the floor. That's wooden.
No, it isn't the floor.
Could it be this book here? I've heard that some paper is produced from bamboo.
No, keep trying.
Is the building we're in made of bamboo?
Well, it might be. You know that bamboo is sometimes used to make building materials stronger. It's as strong as some metals, actually. But no, that isn't what I'm here to talk about.
Well, what is it? I really have no idea.
It's my t-shirt.
Your t-shirt? Is it made of bamboo?
Yes, it is.
Wow. I thought it was cotton. I never knew that you could make clothes from bamboo.
Well, you can. When bamboo plants are used to make material for clothing, they are cut until only tiny little pieces are left. These little pieces are mixed with a liquid to make a very soft fabric. It feels incredibly comfortable against your skin. A lot of baby clothes are now made of bamboo, and they're sold here in the store. Parents who bought the clothes said their babies were very happy wearing them.
Well, that's amazing. The fabric does feel incredibly soft, and it looks great, too. But what about the environment? That's always the most important question, isn't it? Is our planet affected by growing bamboo?
Well, bamboo is actually great for the environment. You don't need much water to grow it, and dangerous chemicals aren't involved in the growing process. It doesn't need much room either, because the plants grow very close together. Bamboo is better for the environment than materials like cotton.
Really? Well, that's good to know.
Another amazing thing about bamboo clothes is that they keep you warmer in winter than other clothes. And in hot weather, bamboo fabric keeps wetness away from our skin, so we feel cool and dry.
Well, that is great news. Is it becoming very popular around the world?
Yes, it is. Because bamboo grows so quickly, it's cheaper than some other materials, so it's become a very popular alternative for clothing.
In that case, I think I'm going to buy a bamboo t-shirt right now. What colors do you have? I like red and tan.